Thank you. Thank you. I was listening to Dr. Goodnoy, and I was thinking about myself. I'm a Capricorn. If you believe in astrology, I'm a Capricorn. If you don't believe in astrology, I'm still a Capricorn. And a Capricorn is an earth sign and tends to be very practical. So when I look at this wonderful business of Omega, I see it from a very practical standpoint. I see that we can help an enormous number of people, and we can help ourselves as well. And I like to think of the wonderful health benefits that this can offer, and I also like to think of the wonderful financial benefits that this can offer. So other people have spoken about the spiritual benefits. Let me speak about the practical benefits and give you some practical ideas. So my first question is, how many people here would like to double their income? Wonderful. Those who didn't raise their hand obviously did not understand the question. Well, I'm going to show you how to double your income. I'm going to give you several ideas, several ways, that are guaranteed to work if you will work. They are sort of like a car. I will give you the key to the car. You turn it on, you can drive it anywhere you want to go. These are the ways that people have doubled and tripled and quadrupled their income over the years, and they've worked for millions of people, and they will work for you if you will work. That's the wonderful thing. Nothing happens without your working. So let me ask you another question. Who is the most important person in this room? Yes. And this is the starting point of success. It changed my life completely when I first learned it. When Barbara and I first learned this, is that you are the most important person in this room. You are the most important person in your world. There's no one in the world more important than you. When you get up in the morning, who do you think about? You think about yourself. There is a philosophy called solipsism, which basically means that each person thinks of themselves as the sun, and all the world goes around them. And this is okay. This is the way it is. This is to assure survival and success and happiness. But you are the most important person, and how important you feel you are determines your whole life. It determines how happy you are. It determines your relationships. We call this your level of self-esteem. And your level of self-esteem is how much you like yourself, how much you respect yourself, how much you value yourself. And all of us fight with this issue of self-esteem. All psychological problems that make people unhappy come from low self-esteem. All truly successful people have high self-esteem. They like themselves. And the more you like yourself, the more you like other people. And the more you like other people, the more they like you. So all successful people in our business have high self-esteem. They like themselves. They consider that they are valuable and important, and what they are doing is valuable and important. Someone said yesterday about MLM network marketing that the hardest part of this is selling a product that doesn't work. And most MLM companies sell products that don't work. They're basically lies. They're basically frauds. And at the end of the day, people realize that whether you take the product or not, it has no difference. So you can be proud of this product. You can feel happy and proud. So I want you to say these words in whatever language. Just say the words, I like myself. And even more, say, I love myself. Because the more you like yourself, and the more you love yourself, the happier you are. And the more you like and love other people, and the more they love and like you back, and they want to join your business, and they want to be part of your organization, and they're open to your influence. We have four children. When we grew up, we started off with four philosophies about raising children. We now have four children and no philosophies. But the one thing that we knew is we wanted to raise our children with high self-esteem. And raising them with high self-esteem means telling them all their lives how much we love them and how good they are. And people say, well, won't your children have too much self-esteem? Well, there is no danger of that. And so we've told our children how much we love them and how good they are all their lives. And our children have grown up with high levels of self-esteem and self-confidence. The most wonderful thing you can do for other people is to tell them how good they are and what great possibilities they have. So here's the second question is, what is your most valuable financial asset? Now, Eric said yourself, and that's quite correct. This is the breakthrough. I'm writing a book on it now. It's already contracted with a major New York publisher. But your greatest financial asset is your earning ability. To earn money. Sometimes this is called your earning power. The Nobel Prize winning research says that your ability to earn money is really as much as 90% of your asset. You could lose your house and your car, you could lose your home and your business and all your money. But as long as you have your ability to earn money, your skill set, you can go back out and you can earn it all back again. So your earning ability is your ability to get results that people will pay you for. Now here's what we have discovered, and I talked about it yesterday, is that everyone starts off at the age of 19 or 20 and they have no earning ability. You have no ability to get results. You have no usable skills. Now the question is, what do you do from then on? And what smart people do is usually develop the earning ability. They learn skills that make them valuable. So people will pay them money to use their skills. And the great majority of people don't do that. The great majority of people watch television, have fun in life, socialize, and they don't realize that your earning ability determines your financial future. You cannot earn more on the outside than you were prepared for on the inside. But there's one thing that you can control, and that's yourself. You can control the development of your earning ability. So you'll find that people, as my friend Jim Rohn once said, he said, becoming a millionaire is not the most important thing. It is the person you have to become a millionaire that is the most important. Because you can lose your money through unexpected changes in the economy, through betray you, all kinds of things. But if you have learned how to earn $1 million, you can earn it back again, and much faster. They say the first million is very hard, and the second million is inevitable. Because once you have learned how to do it, you can do it again. And if you lose everything, you can do it again. So your earning ability is the most valuable thing you have. Now, in accounting, they talk about an asset. And they say an asset can be appreciating or growing in value, or an asset can be depreciating or going down in value. If you buy a car, what will happen is that that car loses value every day, every year, until it has no value at all. If you buy any piece of machinery, it loses value. But your earning ability can grow in value every day, every week, all your life. And all top people who double their income, double their earning ability. They just become more valuable and more capable of getting results that people will pay them for. So your earning ability is your most valuable asset, and it's very precious. Everything you have of a material nature is determined by this earning ability, which can be going down if you do not work on it, or it can be going up if you work on it. So here's my next question. What is your most precious resource? What is your most precious resource? And the answer is time. Your most precious resource is time. Everyone has the same amount of time. My friend Dennis Waitley used to say that time comes to you every morning. You get 24 fresh hours. It doesn't matter if you're the richest person in the world, you still get 24 hours. The only question is, what do you do with your time? And what we find is, since everyone has the same abilities, people who are successful use their time differently. Study the time usage of successful people and then duplicate it, do the same thing, you would eventually be rich. Unsuccessful people, the bottom 80%, waste their time. They watch too much television, they entertain themselves too much, they read the newspaper, they follow sports. People sometimes spend their whole life in sports. Now you can become the most knowledgeable person about all the sports in the world, and it will have zero effect on your earning ability. It will have no positive influence on your life at all. As a matter of fact, your television can make you poor. If you watch your television all the time, I can promise you one thing, you're going to be poor. Yeah. So your time is your most precious resource, and most people waste most of their time. I found when I was studied, I was asked to do a program on time management. I said, sure, because I thought time management was a skill like driving a car or riding a bicycle. You do it every so often. And as I began to study time management, I realized, oh my, time management is not an outside skill. It's the core skill of your life, because time management is life management. And if you manage your life, you have a great life. And if you don't, you have a poor life. And all successful people, 100%, use their time well. They're constantly thinking, I only have 24 little hours each day, and I must use that time well. And remember, 80% of people waste most of their time. So your most precious resource is your time. Then this brings us to the next question, is what is the very best investment of your time? What is the very best investment to get the highest return? And the answer is, it is to invest in your earning ability. It's to invest in coming to a conference like this. It's to invest in reading a book. It's to invest in listening to a program. It's to invest in going to a seminar. The very best use of your time is to get better at what you do. To get better and better and better. Now, Napoleon Hill did a study of 500 of the most successful people who'd ever lived, the richest people in America, and he found three discoveries, three breakthroughs. Number one is they all had certain qualities and abilities in common. If he asked each one of them and he put them into his books of success, these are the 13 principles or the 17 principles of all successful people. He said, number two, he said, no one started with these principles. No one knew these success skills when they started. And number three, and this is the most important, he said they were all learnable. You can learn every skill you need to learn. Do you know that sometimes learning one skill can change your life? One skill can change your success? There are many people who have had one idea from one seminar or one book that took their life in a different direction, and forever after they were successful. And so, but what I have found is you never know what that idea is. So you must be constantly taking in lots of ideas. But here's the point. All success skills are learnable. Everyone who has a skill today did not have that skill at one time, and now they do. And so what other people have learned, you can learn as well. There is no difference. I travel all over the world. I have spoken now in 56 countries, and I speak for successful people, and I speak to successful people. And you know that all successful people worldwide have the same qualities. They're well organized, they work hard, they upgrade their skills on a regular basis, they're constantly busy. They're all the same worldwide. And they learn these skills either by reading or, best of all, is by having models. People that you look at and you say, I want to be like this person. And you just watch. Many people's lives have been changed by picking one model, one person who was really successful and just doing what that person does all the time. Your goal in life is, first of all, to select one or more role models and do what they do. And then second of all, become a role model so people do what you do and become successful. So we say that all success skills are learnable. Now, here is one of the great breakthroughs, and I call it the law of three. The law of three says that if you make a list of all the skills that are necessary for success, you'll find that three skills will account for 90% of your income. Three skills, three activities each day will account for 90% of your income and 90% of your success. And so what we do is we ask this magic question. This magic question will make you rich if you answer it correctly. The magic question is this. If you could only do one thing all day long, which one activity would contribute the most to your financial success? If you could do one thing all day long, only one thing. If you could get up in the morning and only do one thing all day long, which one activity would help you the most to double your income? Now, when I ask that question, you know what it is. You know what it is. And many people say, well, I know what it is. It would be recruiting new people to this business. It would be doing more demonstrations for more people, to recruit more people to this business. That's the always the answer in our business. Well, then why don't you do it? And you always have a reason. Well, I'm busy and I am not ready yet and I need to understand the science behind everything. No, you need to get busy. You need to get busy and just do it. Because here's the most wonderful thing is you learn by doing. You don't learn by studying. You only learn by practicing. So therefore, once you have enough knowledge, just begin doing it. When Sam put me through a wanding, which was very impressive, I phoned my best friend, who is an ex-doctor, and I phoned him on my car on the way home from Sam's house, and I said, I have to show you this because it's quite remarkable. Can you come over to my house? And he came over to my house, and an hour after I got home, I lived 1 hour south of Sam, an hour after I remember what Sam did, sit down, close your eyes, clear your mind, let me show you how this works. And I did my first demonstration 2 hours after Sam had done a demonstration on me. And it worked. I called my friend, I said, do you have any pain? And he's about 70 years old. He said, and he never complains. He said, I have this terrible pain in my knee. He said, I walk like this. He said, I've been to doctors. I've had surgery. He said, I take painkillers. He said, I live in a house that has two levels. He said, I'm thinking of selling my house because I can't walk up the stairs. He said, my knee hurts. He's very skeptical, but very open. Good combination. So I said, okay. I said, now Sam said, you sit down and you close your eyes and you clear your mind of your story. And then you go through the process of tapping. And then I said, now I don't know if this is going to work. Because I've never done this before. But I knew it worked for me. So I wanted his knee. Barbara was sitting there. I wanted his knee. And I said, I watched the clock. I did it for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, I said, okay, open your eyes. I said, now, stand up. And he stood up and it went and I think, oh my God. And he said, I can't believe it. He said, the pain is gone. The pain is gone. And he started walking up. He said, it's the first time in 12 years. He said, I've been able to, I have no pain. I cannot believe it. I have no pain. And then he told me about thinking about selling his house because he could not climb stairs. I said, well, we have some stairs over here. Let's try them out. So I took him and he walked up and down the stairs. He said, all the pain was gone. And that was April 9th. And I spoke to him last week. I said, how is your knee? No pain. That's April 9th to today. So, but the point I'm making is this, is that I'm a businessman, I'm practical, I'm a Capricorn, I'm rooted in the earth. But I knew that the only way that you could learn this is to do it. Now I can do it to anybody. So it's so important that you just have a model, follow the model, don't worry about doing it perfectly, just do it. It's sort of like kissing, you know, you can't do it wrong. You can get better at it, but you can't do it wrong. With wanding, you can't do it wrong. I mean, it's not as if you're going to break something or hurt somebody. You cannot do it wrong. You can only do it righter as time passes. So therefore, when we ask this question, what are the three things that will help you the most to double your income? First question is, what would be number one? The second question is, if you could only do two things all day long, what would be the second thing that would help you the most to double your income? What would be the second activity or result that you could get? And the second result would be teaching your people how to do the business. It's always the same. First of all, attracting people by showing them how the wand works, and second of all, teaching them how to help others. And if you could only do three things all day long, which would be number three? And number three is very clear. It's to support people and help them and answer their questions, be available to them on a regular basis. And so those are the three. And so you know that those three account for all your success, 90%. Everything else you do, people think, well, I'm going to work on my computer, and I'm going to listen to a teleseminar, and I'm going to read my materials. No, this is in the 10%. This contributes nothing to your life. The only thing that contributes to your life is, number one, is sponsor people by demonstrating. Number two is teach them how to do it for others. And number three is to support them until they have enough confidence to do it on their own. And so when you wake up in the morning, you have 24 fresh little hours. If you want to be successful, do those three things all day long. And don't do anything else. And don't do anything else. And you just ask yourself this question, is what I'm doing right now helping me to double my income? Is what I'm doing right now going to help me double my income? And if it's not, stop doing it. And don't do it anymore. Be very, very strict with yourself. My friend Zig Ziglar used to say that if you will be hard on yourself, life will be easy on you. But if you insist upon being easy on yourself, life will be very hard on you. And you will meet a lot of people whose main goal in life is to be easy on themselves. And they will never be successful. We say that you do not try to get ducks and teach them to fly like eagles. You try to find eagles and teach them to fly in formation, like other eagles. So if you quack, 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 quack. When you find a duck and they say quack, 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 you say, thank you, have a nice life. And go and find eagles. One of the most important things about selling is this, is you do not find people and try to create within them a desire for our business. You try to find people who already have a desire that is not yet focused. They're already hungry. The one thing that Sam and I, and Eric and I, and Garun and I have found, is the one quality for successful people is that they are hungry. They want to be successful. They don't know how yet. They have not got a clear direction. They may have tried many things, but they are hungry. They have desire. They want to be successful. Your job is to find that type of person. If a person says, well, I don't know. I like to watch television. I'm happy with my life. You say, good. Have a nice life. Bye-bye. And let them go off. Quack, 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 quack. So I told you yesterday that I began studying self-made millionaires, and I have found that self-made millionaires have certain qualities, and all these qualities are learned, and all of these qualities are learnable, which means you can learn the qualities of being a self-made millionaire. Can anybody here ride a bicycle? Can anyone drive a car? Can anyone use a modern cell phone? Of course. At one time you could not use these, and now you can use them competently all day long. If you can ride a bicycle, drive a car, or use a cell phone, you can learn any success skill. You can learn it through practice and repetition. Now, what happened when you rode your bicycle the first time? You fell down. What happens when you try anything new the first time? You fall down. Now, what is the difference between winners and losers? It's winners get up, and they keep getting up until they can ride the bicycle all day long. And what do losers do? They lay down there and they cry. Oh, I hurt my leg, I hurt my arm. I phoned this person, they didn't come to my house. Wah, 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 wah. Yes. If they're not crying, they're quacking. You know, if they're not going wah, wah, they're going quack, 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 quack. So your time is your most precious resource. So what does that mean? Is don't waste your time on people who have no success in them. Waste your time, spend your time on hungry people, people who want to be pointed in the right direction. Give them the tools. Keep sorting. Remember, if you have to talk to 10 people to find one good person, go quickly. Talk to the first 9 people as fast as you can. So here are 7 qualities of self-made millionaires. Number one, and Rick talked about this, is dream big dreams. Have big dreams. Only big dreams motivate you to get out of bed in the morning. Only big dreams help you to stay excited. And the way you dream big dreams is you imagine that 5 years from now, your life is going to be perfect in every way. Imagine 5 years from now, your income will be perfect. Your family life will be perfect. Your home, your car. Imagine that 5 years from now, your health will be perfect. And imagine 5 years from now, your financial situation, your bank account will be perfect. If they were all perfect in every way, what would they look like? How much money would you be earning in 5 years? How would you look physically? How would you be? What would your family life be like? Your lifestyle, your home, your vacations? How much money would you have saved up and working for you if your life was perfect? And this becomes your dream. One of the ways that we create a big dream is imagine the very best income, the highest income you've ever had in 1 year, and then add a zero at the end. And that becomes your dream. And you see, the first time you do this, this is quite natural. It's like a new organ. The body tends to reject a new organ. When you put a new big dream in your mind, there's a tendency to reject it. To earn 10 times as much as I'm earning today? Impossible. So all I ask you to do is say, well, it may be impossible, but let me ask you this question. Is there a one chance in 1,000 that you could increase your income 10 times? Is there one chance in 1,000? Yes, there's one chance in 1,000. I mean, there's maybe one chance, okay. How about two chances in 1,000? What could you do to increase the probabilities? What could you do to make it more likely? And the answer is, get better at what you do. So number one is to dream big dreams. Number two is to develop a clear sense of direction. And this is something that I have studied all my life. It's changed my life and the lives of millions of people, is you've got to have goals. You have to have clear goals. You have to know exactly where you are and exactly where you're going, and you have to have a plan to get there. So I want to give you 7 keys to achieving goals, a simple exercise that can change your life. And here are the 7 steps. Number one is to decide exactly what you want. Most people don't know what they want. Probably 80% of the population, they say, I want to be happy, and I want to be rich, and I want to be thin, and I want to be popular, and I want to have a happy relationship. But these are not goals. These are fantasies. These are like dreams. People who are smoking dope can have these dreams. Because they're just fantasies. All human beings have these as fantasies. They are not goals. And many people think, well, I have goals. I want to be happy. Yeah, I'll give you a smack, happy. Happiness is a result. Happiness is never a goal. You become happy when you're doing with people you enjoy and you're getting good results. So you're successful. Then you feel happy. All right? So in other words, a goal is something that's very clear. If I said to you, would you like to have a beautiful home? Yes. What would it look like? Oh, it would be beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Well, I mean, what size? How many bedrooms? How would it be laid out? Don't worry. It would just be beautiful, beautiful. You know, you would say, this person is crazy. How could you ever have a beautiful home if all you had was a fantasy home? But if you want a beautiful home, you have a blueprint, and you lay it out, and you design it, and you find the right piece of land, and then you get the correct building materials, and you build the home a step at a time. So you need goals like you need a blueprint. Number one, decide exactly what you want. Number two is write it down. Write it down. Write it down. The turning point in your life, like driving a car, the turning point in your life is when you write your goals down on paper. Write it down. Write it down. Write it down. Number three is set a deadline. It's set a date that you want to achieve your goals. It's amazing. People say, well, I want to double my income. When? Oh, sometime? Next few years? No. Set a goal to double your income in 1 year. All right? Now, will you achieve your goal? Some will achieve their goal before that. Some will achieve their goal after that. But just set a deadline. Your subconscious mind needs a deadline. It needs a target to aim at. When you set a deadline for your subconscious mind, it becomes activated and it starts to look for ways to help you to achieve your goal on your deadline. So, is to make a list. And you make a list of everything that you could do to achieve your goal. I could do this and I could do that. I could learn this and I could learn that. I could go here. I could phone this person. You make a list, make a list. Remember, there is a miracle that takes place between the head and the hand. When you write things down, you transform them on paper. They become crystallized like a blueprint. If all you have them is in your mind, going around in circles, it's no different than a crazy person who has ideas spinning in their mind. But when you write them down clearly and specifically, they become something tangible, something hard that you can work with. So that's number four. Number five is to organize your list. What should you do first? What should you do second? What's more important? What's less important? In other words, you make a plan. And this is what I can promise you. A person with a goal and a plan will accomplish 10 times as much as an equal person with no goal and no plan. The great majority of people fail because they do not have written goals and plans. The great majority of people succeed because they have written goals and plans. Does it take a little time to write down your goals? Yes, but it increases your likelihood of success by 10 times. And every time I meet people around the world who have gone from nothing to becoming very wealthy, they did it with a goal and a plan. None of them just went out and, you know, did their work and were happy and so on. They had a goal and a plan, and they worked on their plan every day. They used their time well every day. They thought in terms of the most valuable use of their time every day, every minute. Step number six is to take action. And this is what Sam was talking about, is when you leave this conference, the most important part of this conference is what you do afterwards. And it's not only what you do afterwards, it's what you do immediately afterwards. It's whatever you do immediately. Because the excitement of this conference will wear away, almost like cigarette smoke disappears in the air. The only question is, will you take action? And will you take action immediately? And it doesn't matter what you do, but do something. Do one thing. Do anything that will help you move ahead in this business, but take action. Now, number seven, and this is the key to achieving goals, this is the most important trick of all. If you will do this alone, your success will be guaranteed. You will double your income, you will be financially successful, you will achieve all your goals, and you'll be happy, rich, thin, and popular. And it's very simple, is do something every day. Do something every day to achieve your goals. Do something every day to achieve your goals. Now, I told you yesterday about David Porter, the person who produced 100 hit songs, but he actually produced 1,000 songs, and only 1 in 10 was a hit. He said something else in that interview, which I really liked, and they asked him, Mr. Porter, what do you do on the weekends for fun? What do you do for fun and relaxation on the weekends? And he said, I don't understand your question. He said, well, what do you do for fun, to relax? He said, you don't understand. He said, I love my work. He said, I work on weekends. I don't know any successful people who don't work on the weekends. I don't know any successful people who take the weekends off. There aren't any successful people who take the weekends off. And I had been working 7 days a week, but I work 7 days a week because I love my work. I have to discipline myself not to work. Barbara has to go and turn things off, you know, throw my computer away, because I love to work. It's hard for me not to work because I love it so much. And all successful people love their work so much that it's hard not to work. They don't think, oh, I'm going to take a vacation. They think, how can I combine my work with my vacation? So, number seven is do something every day that moves you towards your goal. If it's a 90-day challenge to recruit one person every day for 90 days, if you could recruit one person every day for 90 days, you could fly here next year in your own private jet. Think about that. And so, say you recruit one person each week for the next year. Could you recruit one person each week? There's 168 hours in a week. 7 days, 168 hours. Do you think you could talk to 10 people in 168 hours? Do you think you could find one person who would be interested in the business? If you did that for a year, that's 52 people. Now, just by the law of probability, some of those must be successful. And they must know people who will be successful. If you simply do something every single day. So here's the exercise I'm going to give you. And the exercise is, you're going to take a piece of paper like this after the seminar. And I want you to write down at the top today's date and the word goals. And then I want you to write 10 goals. Just 10. And not 9, not 11, but 10 goals that you would like to accomplish in the next year. And you write them in the present tense. So for instance, one goal would be, I double my income in the next 12 months. I weigh this number of pounds or kilos in the next 12 months. I buy a new BMW or Mercedes-Benz in the next 12 months or in the next 6 months. I do this, buy, and you always give yourself a date. Always write the goal and buy this date. And write down 10 goals plus dates. That's it. Then you take this list after you've written these goals, and I do this for large audiences of thousands of people, but I usually have more time. And then you take this list and you ask this question. Imagine that you can accomplish all of these goals sooner or later, but you can accomplish one goal within 24 hours. If you could accomplish any one goal on your list within 24 hours, which one goal would help you the most to improve your life? Which one goal would have the greatest positive impact on your life? Which one goal would help you the most to double your income? And you look at those goals and you say, if I do this, you know what my goal is? I recruit 10,000 Omega distributors by the end of 2011. That's my goal. If I do that, put a circle around that, that'll have more of an effect on having a house and a car and everything else. So that becomes my number one goal. And that's a goal I think about all the time. I get up in the morning, I think about that goal all day long. All day long, I keep asking, am I doing something to move toward that one goal? If I achieve that one goal, I can achieve all my other goals. And so then you think about your one goal all day long, and you write it down, and you make a plan, and you organize your plan, and you take action on your plan, and you do something every day that moves you toward that one goal. And don't try to accomplish every other goal. Try to accomplish the one goal every single day, 7 days a week. And I promise you, every day that you do this, you become more and more focused. It's like a skier that skis. You go faster and faster and faster with greater and greater focus and greater control, greater power, greater concentration. And as you move faster, you have more energy and you feel happier and you feel more powerful. And as you have more success, your self-esteem goes up and you like yourself and you feel happy and you want to do more and more of it. And you can start off going slowly, and as you work on your goal every day, you start to go faster and faster and faster and feel better and better and better. And a week, a month from now, people will say, you have changed. There's something different about you. You don't waste any time. You're busy all the time. You have tremendous energy. You're positive and powerful in your personality. Your handshake is strong. Your gaze is powerful. Because you're working on your goal, your biggest single goal, every single day. And this is the key to becoming a self-made millionaire. This is the key to great success. Now, some other quick techniques. Step number three is to commit to excellence, is to commit to becoming very good at the three most important things you do. Make a decision that you are going to be in the top 10% of people in network marketing worldwide in recruiting, training, and supporting your people. You're going to be very, very good. Read everything you can. Listen to everything on the website. Go to every meeting that you possibly can and just practice, practice, practice. The studies that are coming out now say that the difference between the people at the top and the people in the middle and the bottom is practice. It's top people just practice the most important skills every single day, and they get better and better and better. So make a decision that you're going to be in the top 10% in your field. You're going to be very, very good at sponsoring and recruiting. Very, very good at training and teaching. Very, very good at supporting and managing your people, and just practice every day. Remember, you cannot get worse at these things by doing them. You can only get better by practice. And so if you combine goal setting, doing something every day, with practicing and becoming better, you're going to move up the ladder of success very quickly. Step number four is to accept complete responsibility for your life. One of the things that we is the reason that people fail is because they make excuses. So I ask you this question. Everybody here wants to double their income. Is that true? So why aren't you already earning twice as much? Why aren't you already achieving all your financial goals? There are people in Omega who are earning wonderful livings. Why aren't you earning twice as much already? Now, when I ask that question, the first thing you'll think of is your favorite excuse. Well, I'm very busy, and I don't understand it yet, and I haven't learned all these skills, and I don't know that many people. And you'll think of all your favorite excuses. So the key to success is to get rid of your excuses. I just wrote a book this year called No Excuses. No Excuses, The Power of Self-Discipline. And so what you do is you say, I am responsible. I'm responsible for my life. I am where I am and what I am because of myself. I'm here because of my own choices and my own decisions. And if I'm not happy with my situation, then it's up to me to make different choices and make different decisions and take different actions. But the key is always accept responsibility. Don't blame other people. Don't complain about your situation. Don't make excuses. And don't criticize other people. Just say, I am responsible, and get busy. Take action. Take action. Now, the fifth key for self-made millionaire is to dedicate yourself to lifelong learning. Dedicate yourself to getting better and better every single day. Read on a regular basis, turn off the television, listen to audio programs, preferably Brian Tracy audio programs. But listen to audio programs in your car and attend every seminar you can and take notes. Most amazing thing to me is people go to a seminar like this with some of the smartest people in the world, and they take no notes. Do you know something? A genius cannot remember what they learned in a seminar, and you are not a genius. And for people to sit there like this, where are they? They might as well be up in their room watching television, because you can't learn anything sitting there like that. You've got to be taking notes and writing down all the time. That's what Arun said yesterday, write it down, write it down, write it down. So it's really important that you write notes. Because again, the miracle between your head and your hand is when you write things down, you actually write them into your mind. You write them on a screen in your mind, and they go and become part of your hard drive. If you don't write them down, they just disappear in the air. So learn. Dedicate yourself to lifelong learning. Number six, I'm just going to give you seven. Number six is... commit to excellence. Number six is develop a reputation for speed and dependability. Sam has talked about this. Other people have talked about this. The number one thing that makes you successful is you move quickly. All successful people are intensely action-oriented. If you get a good idea, move fast. If you hear something here, move quickly. If you think of something to do, move on it. If you have an opportunity, phone someone. But whatever it is, take action and move quickly. When you get an idea, move fast, because all successful people move quickly, and unsuccessful people either move slowly or they don't move. So develop a reputation. The best people I know in this business, if you call them with a question or a problem, they solve it immediately. They call, they answer, they email, they text message, but they're on top of everything all the time. So develop a reputation so that when people say, if you need something done, give it to that person, because that person will do it quickly. That will guarantee your success as much as anything else. And number seven is develop the habit and the quality of courage. You see, the number one obstacle to our success is fear. This fear holds us back. What if it doesn't work? What if I fail? What if people criticize me? What if people reject me? What if I lose my time? What if I lose my money? And so people have this fear. But the fact is that most things you try won't work. You're going to fail 9 out of 10 times. Failure is the price of success. There is no success without failure. So develop the habit of courage. And when you think of something, have the courage to just do it. Now, here's an interesting point. Everyone is afraid. Everyone's afraid of failure. Everyone is afraid of loss. Everyone is afraid of disapproval or criticism. But strong people overcome their fears and they take action even though they're afraid. Now, the wonderful thing is that if you keep taking action, even if you're afraid, what happens to your fears? Your fears go away. Your fears eventually become smaller and smaller and smaller, and your courage gets higher and higher and higher. And soon you reach the point where you're not afraid of anything. You're not afraid of anything. You'll talk to anybody. You'll go to any meeting. You'll do a demonstration anyway. You're not afraid. And when you're not afraid, your whole world opens up for you. So there's two parts of courage. The first part of courage is the courage to begin, to take action with no guarantees. The second part of courage is the courage to persist in the face of adversity and disappointment. Now, the price of success is to face disappointment over and over again. Winston Churchill once said that success is going from failure to failure with no loss of enthusiasm. In other words, it's to keep on over and over again, no matter how many times you fail, knowing that failure is just the price you pay to succeed. You cannot succeed without failing. You must be prepared to fail over and over. If you do that, you must know, just like a seed that is planted and is growing under the earth, is that you are getting better and better. Every time you fail, you learn and you get better. And at a certain point, your flower begins to grow. It comes above the surface and it grows and grows and grows. So you develop courage by, first of all, taking action, and second of all, continuing, persisting in the face of all adversity. Now, my time is up, so I want to leave you with the most important that I have made with regard to this business. And I call them the five rights. Number one, this is the right company for you. This is the right company that offers you everything that you need to achieve all your goals. Number two, it has the right products. It has the products that are going to sweep the world, that are going to sell a million and then a billion. It has the products that will enable you to achieve all of your financial goals because they work and they bring about benefits far beyond their cost for the people who buy them. Number three, it's the right people. You've met the people here inside the business, inside the company and outside, and the most important thing in a business is to surround yourself with excellent people like Eric and Arun and Sam and all the top people in this business. So you've got the right company, the right products, the right people. Now, fourth of all, it's the right business opportunity. This business opportunity enables anyone starting from anywhere to become successful because you're getting in right at the beginning. People are always saying, I wish I had started with that company when it was young. This company is young. This company is just beginning. It has only done less than 1% of the business that is possible. When Sam and I first saw this business, we said, my God, this is going to be a $1 billion business. And we were, yes, that's the first thing I saw, the first thing you saw. We said, this is going to be a $1 billion business. And if it's a $1 billion business and they pay out 56% of revenues, that means they're going to pay out in the next 2 or 3 years $560 million. Well, just between you and I, I'd like to get a little bit of that. You know, my cup is out. I'll take some. And finally, number five, the fifth right, is this is the right time. This is the right time for you. It's the right time for this product in the world today. It's the right time for you and I to put everything we have into this business to make it a great success, to achieve all our goals, to become self-made millionaires, and to fly here in our private jets in years to come. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Brian Tracy.
Thank you.